Hello my friends. First of all, thank you for such a good feedback about my first video with dry fire drills. That's why I decided to make a second one right away. This video is about reloads in general and the weak hand reload in particular. I often hear that you need to have huge hands to hold 4 short shells and that it's very difficult. Guys, I wear small sized gloves and my hands aren't that big. So in this case, size doesn't matter. Proper technique is the key to fast and reliable reloads. Remember, when you start dry fire training, start slowly and smoothly. There is one important recommendation. Place your rig the way it is comfortable for you to grab first shot shells and the last ones, without moving your rig during the course of fire. Let me explain how to grab shot shells. Your arm and your wrist should be relaxed, but you need to have firm grip on the shot shells. That way you can be sure that your shot shells won't fall off your fingers and you will be able to load them into a shotgun. But a relaxed arm means that you will be able to make a fast and smooth move. If your muscles remain tense, then you won't be able to load the shotgun. This is also true for all other movements. Try to be relaxed to be fast. Let's start with option 3. Shotgun unloaded, chamber empty. And there are several life hacks which can save you some time. Position your shotgun to make loading port as close to shot shells as possible. Move it a little to the back. Hold the forehand at the very beginning with just several fingers so that your hand is closer to shot shells as well. Everything I told you about is made in accordance to the rules. Your shotgun touches competitor at hip level. Shotgun is held in both hands, but you just made your life a little easier. Now, when you hear a beep, start rotating your shotgun with your left hand while moving it to the shot shells, and finish rotation with your right hand. And that is the moment when there is one important technique. Do not rotate your shotgun. Your hand should hold the shotgun as it held it before. Try rotating it using your wrist. And you are going to feel tension in your wrist, and that's okay, you will get used to it if you spend enough time dry firing. And if it feels that you cannot rotate the stock enough, that's when your elbow comes into play. Use your elbow to push the stock to your body, and that's one of the key elements of weak hand reload. Why? Because when you finished reload and want to shoulder a shotgun, it jumps out thanks to tension and rotation you gave it. You see, it jumps out really fast if you did everything correct. Rotate your shotgun, put your hand on the shot shells, grab them firmly, put them on a carrier, load first 2 rounds in one solid motion. Then load 2 next rounds using short move. Try pushing them into the receiver. If you don't push them, shot shells may lift up and hit the edge of the loading port. So try pushing them down. Always look at what you are doing. This will make your reloads more reliable. And another life hack which can save you some time. Start lifting your shotgun while doing the second reload. This will save you some time. After the reload, you need to pull the trigger and chamber around while aiming a shotgun. Like this. And here is how it looks like. So this was option 3. Now let's see how we load the shotgun during the course of fire. Let's imagine you were shooting at some targets and it's time to reload. Rotate your shotgun down with your right hand while your left hand goes to shot shells. Shotgun doesn't need to be too low to load it. It will require more time to lift it up. Load shot shells. Remember that you need to look at what you are doing at this moment. And lift your shotgun. Remember that it jumps out itself if you rotated it correctly. And the last piece of advice. When you are loading your shotgun on the move, it becomes even more important to press your shotgun to your body. Use your elbow to push it to make it as stable as possible. You won't be able to load your shotgun reliably if it's not stable. So, that's all for today. I hope this video was useful for you. Please leave a comment if you liked it. And next video will be about strong hand reload. Bye! Here is how it looks like. There are several life hacks which can save you some time. After the reload, you need to pull the trigger. So that's all for today. I hope this video was reliable.